and welcome back. As always, we're back again.
Hi!
We're very excited to watch more Jessica Jones. Oh, it's pretty darn scary so far. This Kilgrave guy, I'm not too fond of at all.
No, but we finally saw what he looks really, like.
Yeah.
He's creepy.
Mm-hmm. And thank you again, guys, for your comments, explaining certain things to us when we have questions. And when I was asking about that family, when Kilgrave went in and told the kids to hide in the closet, the girl said she had to pee.
Oh.
I guess it was a pool of pee, so the kid just... Because he did say you can go in there. It looked like thick red. Like, it looked like blood to me. It didn't look like urine.
But that
makes me feel better that that's what that was. Yeah. I mean, we freak out, and he was cleaning the knife afterwards. So I was kind of like, what happened? But... Again, it was a clean knife, the way he was wiping it, and there was no blood on the napkin or anything. But, yeah, so that's what that was. I'm happy the kids survived, and he just left them alone. But, yeah, so, anyways, I like Luke.
We like Luke.
He is, well, he's very attractive for one thing, and I like his character so far, and he's
super cute. He seems like a very sweet guy, too.
Yeah. He's guarded. He's had some stuff happen to him. I'm sure we're going to learn more.
Right. Well, his wife died.
Really sad. And we learned a lot about Jessica,
and how
too.
She died.
Yeah, because Jessica was able to fight off Kilgrave, apparently, and take off from him after she ended up killing Luke's wife.
Yeah.
But why? Like, there's all these questions. Why did that happen? You know?
Why did he make her do that?
Unless he's just a psycho who likes to just mess with people, but he might have more to him. There might be more story there.
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
Yeah, it's
seems
crazy.
Like he's obsessed with her.
Oh, yeah, because I guess she was the only one who was able to, like, break his spell or break through his powers for her to be able to walk away from that. And he was, like, kind of freaking out, like, Jessica, come back or whatever. Pretty scary. Like, to have that kind of power over anyone, and you can do multiple people at a time, and you don't even have to be close to them like you are initially, and then they just keep going until they... do what you wanted, and then they're done.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I have to keep jumping off this bridge or jump off this building until I do it. I can't, like, not think about it. Because then you have all these innocent people involved, and, you know, you're trying to save people and not get killed. And, yeah, it's pretty bad. I don't like this guy. He's pretty freaky.
He is.
Yeah.
Thor needs to come down with his hammer.
Yeah,
out of nowhere. Die.
Squash him.
Yeah, squash him. But yeah, so I think we should get into it.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
It's really scary, though. It's definitely darker than Daredevil, I feel like.
I do, too.
Yes,
definitely.
Yeah.
104, a.k.a. 99 Friends.
All it takes is one word, and they're no longer in control.
Wow. That's how he does it?
All they know is a singular, intense need to photograph me.
So he has people doing it for him?
That's the crazy part. Like, it could be anyone,
crazy?
You know? I know she's looking for someone, but...
Audrey Eastman. I know I'm early. I just want to get this over with. So is that sign just for show, or do you actually have an office?
Oh, she's so annoying.
Yeah,
oh, my God. Throw her out the window.
Ugh.
Oh,
man has been trying to get into his apartment for, like, 5 minutes.
Wouldn't be his first affair, either. Some people can't keep their lives in check.
She's so paranoid. And nosy.
Yeah, look at her. Yeah.
How long have you been in business?
God.
Why do you ask?
Don't touch my stuff.
The kind of pictures you're asking for, they're hard to look at.
That's what I pay my shrink for.
Circle of life.
Look, Trish, what's going on? He knows I'm alive.
Oh, Trish.
Kilgrave sent that cop back to...
Just to mess with her?
Oh, my God.
No, he's trying to get in.
Yeah.
Oh, that is freaky. So, yeah, just that determined.
Yeah.
Get the ram.
Wow.
Can't you call...
Record it.
Can't you call the cops?
Is a camera. Can you record
cops?
It?
You showed the body.
He thinks he killed you.
Oh, so they're... Because he said body.
Nice that look.
Yeah.
So he's guilty. He feels guilty.
Yeah. He wants to cover it up.
Come on. You can use some air.
Okay, so the initial
you've seen it. The best
idea of her dead
her is stay away.
What happens when he finds out that she's still alive?
I'll handle it.
He'll send somebody else, won't he?
It will end when I stop.
He's
it.
A good cop.
No idea what's involved here. I think I know a way to get her off Kilgrave's hit list, but it's gonna be painful.
In what way?
In 3, 2. If he's listening, and I think he is, I want to apologize. I hope he forgives me.
Really? Would that really help?
Uh-oh.
Jess?
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Ooh, yeah.
Is right
wow, see?
Plain sight.
Uh-oh.
Jess? What if the apology...
Oh, look at her.
What the neck.
Oh my god, that's awesome.
Oh god.
Sort of. How can you trust any client after what happened with Hope's parents? Useful skill. How
will you know? It'd be so funny if someone saw her.
His effect has limits.
I've never seen his voodoo last longer than 10 hours, 12 tops.
Okay, at least it washes off.
Security camera.
Seen so many.
Plays like pictures.
We have cameras all over the city. You got times, dates, locations.
Texting him to you now.
That's cool. It's very trusting right away, but she did save him.
Mm-hmm. And I promise you, after this circus is over, I will take you anywhere you want to go.
Okay.
Oh, come on. Wendy, you don't have exclusive rights to every restaurant we've ever been to.
Just the one where you proposed. Let's just go somewhere else.
No.
She orders you the
Oh my god, how awkward.
Oh my gosh.
If there's a diamond right at the bottom, you'll think nothing could ever make you stop feeling happy.
Yeah.
She does not get this goddamn restaurant.
She's so Trinity right now.
Oh. Not killing herself, is it?
Right in front of the window.
Oh, she's...
Oh my gosh.
Target practice?
Oh my goodness. Whoa.
Planning something?
This is really disturbing.
Maybe like so she's trying to kill her husband.
I have a job for you. Who are all these people? They claim they were mind controlled by Kilgrave. Wendy has decided to make this divorce very difficult for me. I have a gun-toting client, a spy to find. Do me a favor. Later. Who's first? He lived with me for 2 days. He made me play my cello for him.
He gave me a purple staff. He made me slide it up my...
Ew!
Check that ear.
Dark hair.
And he said, nice jacket. You want to give it to me, right? Like an asshole, I handed it over. Now, I know it's not the same as killing my parents, but that limey cocksucker owes me $5,000.
Limey?
Yeah, that accent. He's British.
Get up.
What a waste. Solve so many problems with his gift.
Gift?
I just meant if he was on our side.
Whose side exactly would that be?
Ooh. Oh my goodness.
Don't worry about that.
Yeah, yeah.
Sweet glass.
Hey. Hey, I got your movie. Hey, what are you looking at? Huh?
Oh, it's okay.
What the hell
he's
are
okay.
You looking at, huh?
He's okay.
What?
He's okay.
Watching.
Hey, he's probably watching the ceiling melt.
That poor guy, I feel bad for him.
He's okay,
so messed
yeah.
up.
She's
yeah.
like his big sister.
Now I know how it feels. Someone watching your every move. Seeing you in private moments.
It's not a comfortable feeling. Hopefully that's the same bottle. Watch.
Jessica! Are you Jessica?
Okay.
Oh, the poor little girl, really?
Oh, come on.
Patsy Walker is safe. For now.
Oh, that's weird.
You're a bitch. You left him there to die in the street. Like a goddamn dog.
Stop it.
Oh my goodness.
You turned everything to shit.
Oh my god.
That's him going through her.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Did he send Audrey? Was he ever talking to target practice? Wait.
Mommy, where's mommy?
It's okay. I'm going to help you find your mom.
Oh, no.
Stay away from her.
Oh my god, this is so bizarre.
Oh, how messed up.
Wow, yeah, he's just controlling. He's so messed
up. He's so bad, yeah.
I just want to make this right.
You're not coming there, don't.
I don't trust that with Kilgrave again.
I think...
I got something for you.
Yeah.
No,
I think it means
don't,
well, but...
I
don't want anything from you.
It's personal.
No,
yeah,
see?
It's personal.
No.
You can't do that. You can't open sure. it.
I wouldn't,
can't
but...
Win.
Good. Please okay. don't.
Put it on the floor.
Don't open the door.
He's just going to run in.
Oh my god.
You can't bring it in there because it could be
well.
Anything.
Could be anything in there. Oh.
Okay.
Where's it going?
Protect yourself.
Did you open it? I just want you to feel safe.
Does the camera record?
Still there?
I hope she doesn't point it through the wall. She is!
Oh my god.
Don't do it. Don't do it. Okay.
Wow.
What?
Oh my goodness, what the heck?
It was like that cat commercial when I was watching
yeah,
turns
right?
on the porch.
Did she put some shades on.
Oh my.
That woo! He's in his suit still.
Hi, it's Audrey Eastman.
Uh-oh.
Where are you?
Oh, that's so weird.
Jessica.
Oh, that's she's her in purse. There with him.
Yeah.
Get her on the plastic.
How?
Get her on the plastic?
Hey, Carlo.
You shoot at me.
You're bulletproof?
Nope.
Jesus. No. She didn't have laser eyes either, or she would have used them.
Laser eyes? Who said I had laser
eyes?
Oh, see?
Oh, yeah, before.
Dick with the Aston Martin. Pretty sure for the first time this has nothing to do with Kilgrave.
Who's Kilgrave? Is he another one of you people?
Gifted.
It's like calling someone special. They're not special, they're retarded. You're not
gifted.
You're a freak.
Well, you're a freaking jerk.
I saw my mother crushed to death under a building that you people destroyed.
You people.
I was trying to pull my mother out from the rubble.
Perfect.
People, you think you're the only ones with pain? Do you take your goddamn pain and you live with it, asshole? Because I don't work my shit out on other people.
Good lesson.
Wow, Radiator.
The last time I counted, I had 99 gifted friends. This borough alone. Disappear. Nobody hears from you again. We'll stop by tomorrow to make sure you heard me.
99.
Ooh, wow. Oh my gosh.
This poor girl.
I know.
Tough cookie.
It is.
The guy who tried to kill you. It wasn't me.
He's sincere. Like, mm-hmm. He feels really bad, but it's still hard.
I don't blame you.
Trish?
I just hope it doesn't trigger anything. I don't think it will, but...
I disappeared for a week while I was Kilgrave's chauffeur. I was haunted by...
Where did you drive him?
I'm not sure.
Did he meet anyone in particular? Did anyone deliver pictures to him?
Actually, yeah.
Who?
He wore a scarf.
It's details, though.
Blue and white stripes.
He's like, and he's wearing that right now.
Son. It's her neighbor.
I kind of thought
it
might
be. Oh my god.
That sucks, yeah.
Oh, she always, like, protected him.
Yeah. So, was it because he was brainwashed, though? Like, we don't know his connection, really, besides, like, meeting this person.
It's gotta be. He's too innocent when he's with her.
Yeah.
Yes.
And he's always messed up, but that could be why he's messed up, too, because he keeps getting brainwashed or getting paid or feels guilty or something. So, that's why he's always, like, on drugs and whatnot.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow. Did you kind of expect that when she was looking through the camera? Like,
no, I didn't expect him.
The video? Yeah, because I kind of thought that. I'm like, I don't know. And then once we saw the scarf and he's hanging out there, I'm like, it's going to be someone... We know. Who could it be? Who could it be that's, like, kind of innocent? And I'm, like, playing all these different
characters in my head. But it makes sense because he's always home. He's always around.
Yeah, and I'm like, that would make perfect sense because he's so fragile around her and she's always protecting him. Like, how perfect would that be if he had some kind of relation to this whole thing? So I was like, holy crap. So right before when the video was just on him, I'm like, he's going to reveal his head and it's going to be that guy, the neighbor. Yeah.
Never would imagine it.
Last second. I didn't think about it until, like, right beforehand.
But if you think about it, how is he living there? He's got to make some kind of, I don't know if he's paying him.
Yeah,
he must
I don't
be paying
know.
Him if he sees him every day at 10 o'clock.
Yeah,
oh, crazy.
How
well,
funny is that?
That
she just left the support group.
Yes.
Like, I'm sorry, this is...
It's smart that she did that support group. It really is, because that's a good way to get leads and stuff, because he's a weird guy, and he makes people do weird things because he can. Like, he has so much power over people when you have no self-control over yourself, and you'll do anything. That poor guy talking about his kid, leaving him on the curb and driving away and like, not even caring, like, wanting to do that. Yeah, like, against your will. Like, that's insane. That's really
on top
that's
of
scary.
Killing your mom and dad and, you know.
Yeah, all these bad things that he's done.
Yeah,
he's
trying to kill Trish.
So I'm glad she's doing that, and maybe you guys can clarify for us, but with the whole, like, support group, again, the first few people they were interviewing, I was laughing, of course, because they were so over-the-top red eyes, like that guy that was probably on, like, weed or something, and he was just, like, talking about the guy with red eyes, you know, he was
and then the other guy,
or something, whatever he
and then
says.
And the other guy coming out of the water with his purple staff.
That's
and...
Oh, that was so gross. And again, I know that's exaggerated, but at the same time, like, here she brings all of them in for the support group.
That's
so I'm like, what's the purpose of having them all there? Like, I think the girl who was saying, oh, he kept having me smile and stuff. I'm like, well, he's a weird guy, so I would believe that.
I would believe
the
that.
The coat thing, I totally believe, and he did describe him as this British guy or whatever, so I'm like, okay, well, that kind of...
that. They got pregnant.
I don't believe that. When the first guy, her, like, the whole neighborhood. Because people are coming in for any kind of excuse to be innocent, right, you know? Right, so anyone's going to come and be like, oh, yeah, like, Kilgrave made me do this. So I am curious what you guys think about that whole scenario. If you guys think that they were all Kilgrave's victims, or some of them were just making excuses, which I'm sure most of them were making excuses. And the one that was abused or something because she was playing wrong. The
cello, yeah.
Cello, yes. And I'm like, that could be a thing.
That could be because he was listening to classical music or something.
Yeah, that's true. So maybe she was connecting that.
Yeah, who knows?
Who knows? Because it's so random. Like, he's a sadistic person, and there's a lot of bad people out there. So sometimes it could just relate. But when someone says that they were fully out of control, just handing them a $5,000 suit or putting your child on the side of the road and driving away. Right. And then those are messed up.
Driving him for one whole week.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like being his chauffeur, not only relinquishing your vehicle, relinquishing yourself, and you just got arrested for a child endangerment and you lost your marriage.
I can't believe that, like, for him to have that much power, I would think that he would kill him every time, but you can't because then it's too obvious, or maybe you can track him faster and catch him that way. But to be in control of someone for that long and then just be released, like, I'm like, oh my God, thank God you even survived that. But then he lost his wife and he got charged for
his child
and child endangerment. And yeah, so pretty messed up. He messes with a lot of people. And even that little girl, that 8-year-old girl, he knows how to twist and really get to people. It's bad.
Was that Kilgrave's doing, brainwashing that little girl? Or was it Audrey?
Yeah.
Or was it her?
The girl was definitely brainwashed by Kilgrave because the way she was talking and cussing and the way they made her seem so innocent. Kids do cuss now and again, but the way she was talking, and then she goes, don't worry about your friend. She's safer now.
Patty,
he was the one that sent the cop after Trish in the first place. Yeah, that was definitely a Kilgrave move. Okay. And as Jessica said, when she confronted the girl in red, she had no association with Kilgrave. Right. The girl in red didn't like brainwash her or tell her to say
those really
things.
Which really pissed off Jessica even more because she even got more paranoid thinking that she was connected with Kilgrave.
I know, and we all kind of thought that. I thought that, you know? It could be a possibility. Like, how paranoid, because what do you do in that situation? It's so broad. You don't even know, like, how to pinpoint that. Like, anyone could be watching you.
Exactly.
Anyone.
And you can tell. And you can tell even that when she got to the place where, you know, try to catch her husband in the act, I mean, he walked right in. He went right to the bed. Mm-hmm. It was too quick.
Yeah.
And
he still had a suit on, so I was like, wait, what?
The window didn't even have any, like, covering on
that's
it.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
Just,
and then they start
right
arguing,
the
and I'm like, what's going on here? It's just really weird, but... And then when she said, oh, are you there right now? I'm like, oh, that's when we kind of connected. Yeah, like, oh, maybe she is with Kilgrave and they're trying to, like, get to Jessica. They're going to kill her there or something.
Some
trying to capture her or
him.
Whatever. Yeah. So they weren't even involved in that, which I kind of like, too, because you can't have other threats. And it's because of what happened in the beginning when she served that guy and she lifted up the car and she said, oh, I can kill you with my laser eyes or whatever and messed with them. So I love how she said 99. There's 99 of my friends or whatever.
In that borough alone.
So do you think that's true, though, or do you think she's just bluffing just to scare them? I honestly don't know. I'm just asking you guys.
I think she's just bluffing.
You think bluffing? You
because because she knows about Luke, but she doesn't know
about how many others are.
Or and also Kilgrave is probably a gifted.
Yeah, so that would think too. You know, I don't think there's 99. I think that was a bluff number. Again, I'm sure you guys will let us know. But if it's
enough.
A big spoiler that we should know, please don't tell us. But I don't think that really matters. But we know of the Avengers and stuff, and we know that there's a lot of superheroes in the Marvel universe. But just in their borough alone, I'm like, wow, that's a lot of people that's gifted. And for that girl to be like, it's another word for special, and, you know, it just means retarded.
Terrible.
I'm like, that's horrible to talk like that. Like, how arrogant are you to think that you're better than people, you know? Like, and to say you people and stuff. Like,
I hate that.
It's just a macho, like,
hopefully she'll
arrogant
be disappearing the next day.
Yeah, it is.
Just, I know, but anyways, I know she's a character and all that, but still, like, he just irks you, you know? And I love how Jessica just vented, didn't hurt them, but scared the crap out of them and bent, like...
Even that radiator, she picked up that radiator and just threw it across.
Yeah, I love that. And how she was mocking about, or bluffing about being bulletproof, and she wasn't, of course, but she was just saying that because she had a gun freaking pointed at her, so she's not bulletproof, but we saw that she could leap.
No.
Oh yeah, no, she tall sure bounds.
Does. We've heard that before, but we've never seen it. No, I don't think, right? And no. I kind of made me laugh because I was.
And she was even between those two buildings, like crouched in there watching.
Yeah, so she probably leaped up there. I kind of thought maybe she just like climbed.
Like when she was shimmering up there, and
but maybe she leaped and just caught herself when she got up there. That was kind of funny, like just being able to look up and be like, "Wow, is there a person up there?" Like,
what's
up there? You know. Jessica talked about her parents. That her parents died in a car crash.
Yeah,
she's like, "I'm not trying to kill every drunk driver." So that's really sad too.
Yeah, it is sad.
Yeah.
What about that cop? The cop in charge.
I feel bad for him. I do like him, and it seems like they're kind of, whether it's a friendship or not, but you know, Trish went through a traumatic experience with him, and he did too. Like, he is there to protect and serve. He is a true guy. He's a hero. He wants to save people. Yeah. He says he's always wanted to save people. He's always saved people in the past, and
even with his G.I. Joes and Barbie.
And that was cute how they kind of like were able to calm down and talk to each other for a while and kind of warm up to each other. That was good, because Trish, I'm sure she would have a lot of PTSD after something like that as well.
And she believes him because her best friend went through it.
So hopefully they'll be good friends. I kind of saw like they had eyes or something for each other, maybe, but that's I always try to put that together, you know. So who knows?
But you know, not for nothing, but he ruined her door with that, you know, hammer thing or whatever they call it.
Yeah, when he went back in with the battering ram, whatever it was. Yeah, because that time I was like, oh my God, he's all of a sudden triggered again. Like, what the heck? Like, he is going to try to kill her again, because now he found out that she's not dead, but he was saying a body, like we said. And yeah, he brought his friend with them, who I thought maybe was in on it too. Like, maybe killed Grey got around.
Maybe he told his partner, hey, you know, you got to help me out.
Yeah.
That's right.
But no, like, he felt guilty. He kind of remembered certain things that happened and that Jessica saved him when he leaped. They also mentioned in this episode that within usually 12 hours, it wears off or whatever. So so that's a good thing that it doesn't last until they meet their goal. It's good, because God forbid, like, he's telling people, like, oh, jump off this building, or oh, kill this person. And it's not just an ongoing thing for, you know, weeks,
like,
months, years, you know.
The same thing over and over until it succeeds.
So there is some kind of limitation there, which is good.
Not
it's a long time still. 12 hours is a long time. You can do a lot of damage then.
Wow, and she's taking that Profanol everywhere she goes, just in case she meets him.
I know, because what else will you do? Because once you confront him, like, he can just control you, and even though she can most likely resist it, I don't know, like, to what extent. Like, it might take a lot of fighting. She might end up being brainwashed for a while, then fight it again, or maybe she just has a constant resistance to his power now, but who knows?
Yeah.
So it's good that she has that honor.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I really like Trish, too. Like, she's really good. And I know that was hard for her to confess and say, well, confess and say she was wrong. And you know, she said her things or whatever.
That's right.
But I'm like, for him to just let that go, I'm like, really? But he is a messed up guy. Like, he likes to screw around with people and manipulate people.
Does,
yeah, so.
Definitely.
Very good show. I really get into it. I get really scared. And we didn't see any Luke. I wanted to see some more Luke.
You want
to
see Luke.
But, you know, she did break out with him, so. I know, just in photo form. He's my screensaver now. He's my wallpaper. Yeah, she feels guilty about it, but yeah, I know. Like, I really like him, and hopefully he'll be back in the picture at some point, because I think them even teaming up would really come in handy to go after Kilgrave if he doesn't get brainwashed. Hopefully.
You should probably get a discount on liquor, too.
Resistance. Yeah, a discount. Yeah, so you get a little balance there.
She wants to go to the liquor store so much.
All I have to do is smell that, and
then it can be pretty harsh, honestly, depending on what you're drinking, but for sure, like anything like that, scotch, whiskey. Woo. But okay, so as we know with the titles, we understand now that a lot of the titles that we've been seeing so far are labeled AKA, also known as.
Yes.
So that's how it starts, but she's also called Alias, right? Like, her business
Alias
is called Alias.
Investigations.
So,
yeah,
so I like that wordplay there.
Okay, that's good. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I can't wait to watch more. This is a really good series.
Yeah,
I do miss Daredevil, though, I gotta say. But I know we'll eventually get back to that once we're done with this season. Mm-hmm. And we'll go from there. So
very good.
Very good show.
We love you, Jessica.
We love you, Jessica. You're awesome.
Yes. Very good.
So thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you very soon, as always.
Bye,
guys.